Hi everyone, this is Ramalinga Prasad Kuppa. Welcome to my channel Pharma World. Today's topic is how to read and understand pharmacopoeia in a scientific way. Knowledge of pharmacopoeia is most important for any QC chemist. The pharmacopoeia has to be understood to full extent to get best out of it. Let's see how we can move forward on this. Let us look into the basic understanding of the requirement. Pharmacopoeia should be used only as a guide. Pharmacopoeial text is only suggestive and generic in nature. It is necessary to capture the pharmacopoeial text in an imperative, mandatory style. You have to use any pharmacopoeia as a guide only. The text in pharmacopoeia is suggestive and generic in nature. It is not possible to follow the test method step by step as done on the benchtop of the lab. The actual practical activity on the benchtop is not described in the pharmacopoeia. See this example. Prepare a mixture of 0.01 molar sodium borate and acetonitrile 3:1. There are several missing links in this procedure. There is a requirement to know how 0.01 molar sodium borate solution is made, how much quantity to be prepared, what is the grade of sodium borate used, etc. The same is the case with acetonitrile also. If the test method is a HPLC method, you need to use HPLC grade acetonitrile. 3:1 ratio is also not clear. It should be clear on how much volume of 0.01 molar sodium borate is used and how much of acetonitrile is used, how to mix these two, what is the sequence of mixing, etc. You have to write very clearly in your STP. See the other example, dissolve an accurately weighed quantity of USP RS standard in diluent and dilute quantitatively to obtain a solution having a known concentration of about 0.2 mg per ml. That's all is given, no more details are given. So it is very important that you should have an STP which contains the details of how much standard is taken, how much it is diluted to, and you get a final solution which has about 0.2 milligrams per ml. So all these details are required. So it is very important that you draft a standard test method, or call it an STP, with details of each step of the test method. So accordingly, your STP should have details of the grade of sodium borate, acetonitrile, how much to weigh, dilute, with which solvent, maybe water in this case, etc. in a very, very detailed fashion in your STP. Let us see more on this. There are several links in the pharmacopoeial procedures. Few examples include reference to general chapters, some letters are in italics, some references like R, R1, RS, TS, etc. Precautions while making the test solutions. Requirements of specific glassware, example low actinic. These kind of references are there. Here, general chapters refer to the general test methods that are used for testing some of the parameters. Some letters are in italics. There is a separate section that is linked with necessary data. The references like R, R1, RS, TS, etc. are suffixed for several reagents, test solutions, volumetric solutions, etc. There are specific requirements mentioned for each type of reference. You have to use exactly the same quality of reagents, test solutions, etc. In several places, precautions while preparing these solutions must be considered. In some places, it says prepare the solutions freshly. There is a definition for that freshly prepared solutions. That means on the day of testing, those solutions must be prepared. What is low actinic? It sounds to be a different word. In fact, it is a light resistant glassware. To make it simple to understand, it is the amber colored glassware. So you have to draft a detailed STP including all the above requirements of the pharmacopoeia. You cannot use the letters like R, R1, RS, TS, etc. as they are specifically referred to pharmacopoeia. Let us see a typical USP monograph. Let us see the details in this. See, this number 5933 is a chemical abstract service number. See, this is a reference to the general chapter. The ultraviolet absorption is done as per the section 197U. You have to do exactly as prescribed in this. This talks about the details of concentrations of the reagent solutions like 0.1 normal sodium hydroxide solution. Here it says low actinic glassware has to be used. Low actinic means amber colored. This also refers to the concentration of the solution. And see, this italic information is a reagents. You have to refer to the reagent section for this. The USP reference is this. So if you are using the standard, you have to use the USP reference standard. So you have to understand all these points very clearly, very specifically. Let us see more on this. There is a reference to the general chapter 621, that is chromatography. So if you want to carry out this analysis on chromatography, you should understand fully the content and the intent of this 621 chapter. So you have to go through fully. The mode, it says only LC. What is LC? LC means liquid chromatography. You have to refer the exact equipment you have in your lab and write its name in your detailed STP. If you have other equipment also, you can say equivalent. See, the stationary phase is L1. The packing is L1. There are several suppliers who supply the materials of L1 with different dimensions. So you have to be very clear on these things. So you have to be very specific in writing to this column, and you have to write this in your STP in a detailed fashion. If you have an equivalent column, that particular point also you have to refer in your STP. I hope that you understand well on the importance of the pharmacopoeia, how to read, connect to all general chapters, reagents, test solutions, precautions, selection of glassware, etc., and capture all the requirements into your STP in an imperative mandatory style. I am sure by now you understood the meaning of imperative mandatory style. Never do paraphrasing of the pharmacopoeia. This is not a good approach at all. Thanks for watching. For more videos, please do subscribe, like, and share. Thank you.